Now, in the next scene, the main character, Ashitaka, appears. The village girls tell Ashitaka, something strange is happening at the outskirts of the village. So Ashitaka climbs up to the watchtower. There he sees a Tatari god, or a demon, break in Dorui, or earthwork fortification, and enter into the village. This is how the Tatari god looks like in this scene. This is the picture from above. You see how the Tatari god has many legs and crawls on the ground in a furious speed, and see how their legs are surprisingly long? A Tatari god is not a single creature, but a state where numerous monstrous beings that look like snakes or earthworms cling onto a giant wild boar. The reason why you can't tell whether it has 6 or 8 legs is because it represents a demon spider. So what's a demon spider? It's a derogatory term for the powerful families or native tribes who disobey the imperial family. People curse them by saying they're demon spiders. There's a legend that those who disobey the imperial families were defeated by Minamoto no Yorimitsu as monsters who attempted to turn Japan into a world of demons. Miyazaki depicts a world where the story of Ashitaka defeating a huge spider becomes distorted over time, and in the end, authorities turn it into a story about General Minamoto defeating a demon spider. But it's supposed to be a joke for Miyazaki rather than a serious interpretation. But once again, because it's too advanced, we don't get it. And from around the time he made Princess Mononoke, he became Isao Takahata-ish, meaning he started creating his work without thinking whether people would get it or not. That's because he learned that if he made everything easy to understand, then he would lose the inner energy to want to make something. So since then, Miyazaki became not mean, but a creator who makes everything that he wants to make but does not explain them all. Before, he was exactly the opposite. When he made Castle in the Sky, he endured his temptations to do what he really wanted to do, so everything could be depicted clearly. Which you can see in a line by Dola, who speaks her mind to herself and says, "He can be useful, so we might as well take him with us." So Miyazaki separated what can be shown in his movies or not, instead of frequently using straightforward expressions. However, after Princess Mononoke, he started saying, there's nothing that cannot be shown. Kids need to see everything, even something harsh, but I won't show them in a straightforward manner. As a result, the way he depicted the demon spider makes it hard for us to notice it. It's like Miyazaki winking at us and hinting, speaking of demon spiders, they're about the barbarians in Tohoku region, right? Or they're used as a metaphor for the extermination of barbarians in the picture scrolls of Heian era. Shouldn't everyone know that? Now, to help the girls who were attacked by the Tatari god, Ashitaka kills it with a bow. First, he shoots one of its eyes, then between the eyebrows to kill it. As a result, the curse of the Tatari god wraps around Ashitaka's right arm like a snake, leaving a black bruise. This whole sequence is shown very quickly, in the first 3 minutes. After that, the wise woman, or Hisama in Japanese, which means princess, and who is the elder of the village, rushes to the site. Then the wise woman tells the Tatari god, whose slimy stuff has come off and who has turned back into the giant wild boar, "O nameless god of rage and hate, I bow before you. A mound will be raised and funeral rites performed on this ground where you have fallen. Pass on in peace and bear us no hatred." Which means, we will make a large tomb at where your corpse lies and pray to your soul, so please do not curse us anymore. The tomb is kind of like an ancient Japanese tomb. She says she's gonna build it, so please do not curse us. Then the huge wild boar god, who is about to die, suddenly starts talking. "Disgusting little creatures, soon all of you will feel my hate and suffer as I have suffered." And it disintegrates. When he does that, the voice of the wild boar is so deep and rich. It's because, adding to the usual microphone, the voice actor had another microphone taped onto his throat, which picked up the vibration of the throat as well as the voice simultaneously. And they mixed the voice and the vibration to create the effect. Therefore, the breathing sounds contribute to the eeriness of the line which says, disgusting little creatures. After saying that, the wild boar god disintegrates in a very grotesque way. When it dissolves, you can see the teeth exposed, which makes it look like it's smiling. This is the genius of Miyazaki. Miyazaki started drawing scenes from part A, so the depiction of part A and part B is simply just beautiful. The first